It is a rainy Sunday afternoon here at the moment, and I thought that I would sit down and film. I wanted to jump on and do a bit of a sort of get ready with me, even though I'm not going anywhere. I feel like it's been a hot minute since I've actually sat down and actually worn makeup. I want to test something out and also give you guys a bit of a life update. So I hope that the beginning of this year has been a good time for you. For us here, it's been really mixed. We'll get into that a little bit later, but if I seem a little bit off, the energy's a little bit off, I've actually got a double ear infection. I can hear myself speaking and I'm in a lot of pain. So this is actually a little bit of a distraction for me so I can sit down and actually focus on something other than the pain in my head right now. And I also, like I said, wanted to test something out. You guys would have seen, or maybe you would have seen, that Tati Westbrook just released a brand new product, and I'll put it on the screen here somewhere. And it's a blending puff. And I've been using a puff for a long time. Here's one of my favorites. I go and buy the really cheap ones from Daiso, and you get like, I think, two in a pack for $2.80. And I use these to apply powder and just buff like powder into my skin. And I also use it to like create edges, like if I want to create a finer line here underneath my bronzer. And I will apply sometimes, if it's a really like hot day, I will apply some powder and press it into my T-zone if I need my makeup to last a while. Do I sound weird? I feel like I sound weird. Anyway, but another one of my favorites is this big one from Real Techniques. And so what I was gonna do is, look, I really think her product looks great. I actually would purchase it if it didn't actually cost me $50. So the product is $18 US, but with shipping to Australia and stuff, it ends up being just about $50. It's not worth it, so for me. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna wait and see if she releases something that I really like from her in the future. Maybe it's another palette, maybe it's complexion stuff, I don't know. And if I want to purchase that, then I might stick that product onto that. For now, what I thought I'd do is just give this a test and see if this has been sitting under our nose all this time, having all these abilities I didn't know. So if you've never used one of these before, it's just a spongy, like there's a sponge in the middle, and then they've got like a velour-y, velvety finish on top, like a fabric. And then they've usually got a little thing here for your fingers. And you might have seen makeup artists use them before as well to rest on the client's face so they can do eye looks and stuff and not put their grubby fingers on, or their fingers on the model's face or the client's face. So these have been around forever, but like I said, I've never seen them used with liquid products before. So let's go ahead and try this out. This is a very long intro. Let's go ahead and try this out and see if this actually works. I might try the Real Techniques one first and just have a chat about what's happening. So I've got nothing on my face at the moment except some moisturizer. I use Drunk Elephant Lala Retro Whipped Cream, and I actually really like this. I've used this for a few days now. I've had it for ages. So while I check out what foundation to wear today, I haven't worn foundation in 2 weeks, a bit more maybe. So after New Year's, we went away to Daydream Island, and we had a brilliant time there. You can see photos on my Instagram. It's just a beautiful place. So I had no need for foundation or makeup in general. I did bring a little bit with me, but I didn't really wear any. I'm going to grab my L'Oreal Infallible 24-Hour Matte. This is one of my favorites. I need to buy some of this. I don't know how the color's gonna go because I did get a little bit of color while I was away, but let's just give it a go. And I'm applying this much. It's like a pea size amount, pretty much. And I'm going to, I don't know, I'm so scared. So I haven't applied any primer. And I'm just gonna dot that on. Now, I'm not suggesting how this works will be how Tati's product works. This is a completely different product, but it might give me a good idea of, I guess, the finish I might expect. So it hasn't absorbed too much. It's sitting on the surface there, and I'm gonna start swiping this foundation. So it's almost disappearing into the skin, but I don't know if it's disappearing into the puff or into the skin. I guess we'll find out on the nose. So it is definitely giving some coverage, but not a whole ton. Just using that one spot there. I actually can't really press here because it hurts so much. So yeah, I went to the doctor and I got some antibiotics. But I really wish I'd gotten some pain, like relief, because all I've been having is paracetamol. And I couldn't sleep last night. All right, so that's what the puff looks like. And my skin looks like it's really natural looking. I'm just gonna apply a little bit more. So the last time I had a really bad ear infection was like 3 years ago this time, and I'd come back from Daydream Island again, like as well. So I don't know if it's just the swimming part. I have had other ear infections that were not necessarily related to swimming, but I wonder if swimming, like maybe my ears don't drain or something. I don't know what that means, but we're applying a second layer. And it just gives like, I feel like my skin has this really dewy look to it, like really fresh. And it could be that I've had a complete break from makeup for a while. It could be just that I've, I don't know. I'm kind of impressed. I kind of like this. Anyway, I'm jumping all over the place. So we went on holidays and we left Chloe at a vet, like a boarding vet, and she was on medication and stuff like that. So they told us that she took the medication apart from the first day, which she was a bit cranky. And and so they said that she ate and all that sort of stuff. And then we came home, we picked her up, and she was okay for like the first day. A bit weird, she was hiding. Then Friday, she didn't eat at all day. And she just looked really like, before we left, she was skinny. Like she was really skinny, but she still had like the tiniest bit of like meat on her thighs. But when we picked her up, it looked like that little tiny bit had gone. And so I had, I guess, been preparing myself that this was coming. A little bit of foundation just dripped out of the bottle. It's actually not very much. It looks like a lot there, but it's not. I might just apply a little bit more just here. Yeah, so on Friday night, I attempted to give her medication, and she just, her jaw was just locked. Like she wasn't gonna take it. But even with a little, like little pill popper, I couldn't get it in, and she just wouldn't play ball. And I was like, okay, I'm not gonna force it if you're not feeling well. And she was just kind of sitting over her bowl, and like it's a sign that she's obviously very thirsty because she had kidney disease. She was drinking a lot all the time, but she wasn't drinking. And to me, that just, she wasn't feeling well. So Friday night, I kind of gave her big cuddles and kind of had a feeling that, you know, that was it. And then Saturday morning, my husband went out to do some family stuff. And when he came back, I said, I think we need to call the vet. We brought her to the vet at the Animal Welfare League, which is where we first adopted her 9 years ago. And we said goodbye to her, and it was really sad, but I'm really happy that it happened. Happy is probably not the right word. I'm grateful that it happened the way it did, because she was just totally at peace before we put her down. The vet gave her some anti-nausea medication and some fluids, some saline solution, so that she felt a little bit better, maybe just before she passed. And she went to sleep really, really quietly and gently. And my husband and I were like patting her and holding her, and it was really peaceful. And I feel really sad, but it was for the best. All right, it feels really shallow right now, but I've just applied a little bit of concealer, and I'm going to use just the next little bit next to the foundation, and I'm going to just pat that in and see how we go. So yeah, in between that and my ears hurting like nothing else, it's a bit of a rough time, but like we're okay. And I'm really grateful that I used to get, I don't know, not teased, but like I just took so many photos and videos of her all the time. And I'm so glad that I did, because like I can still hear her meowing, I can still hear her purring when I want to. I can look at all the funny like little meme things I made about her. All right, I don't know if you can see this, but it's padded the concealer in really nicely. I'm gonna add a little bit more. I've gone from wearing no makeup to all of the makeup. So yeah, that happened yesterday. And today my husband did a bit of like cleaning and sort of took her litter box and stuff outside, but there's still little bits, because she used to love drinking in the bathtub, so you just have wet paws sometimes. So there's these little prints around the house. Every now and then from a certain angle you can see the little footprints in the house. She wasn't like I miss her presence, but she kind of wasn't her own presence for a while, so it's like we'd already said goodbye. For some reason, I don't know why, but it looks like my under eyes are really bright but it looks pretty good in real life. So I think this Might work. Okay, I'm gonna try some other stuff. Might try some cream products first. I'm gonna use the Hoola Quickie Stick, I think it's called. Quickie Contour Stick. And pop a little bit of that on there, a little bit of that on there. Even though I did, you know, slip, slop, slap, I did get a bit of colour on mostly my body, like my face, not so much, but a little bit. So I'm just gonna take another little piece here. I think Tati's one would probably be a little bit easier to use this way because it's got sides, whereas this is just round. And I'm going to just tap, because I feel like if I swipe, it might rub off the foundation. I'm going to, after this, refilm my project pan. I filmed it before we went away, and then when I just went to look at it edit it, it just didn't look very good. Okay, so what else? So as I said, I took off my S&S nails. I went to the salon just before we left, and I decided that it was time to give it a break. No real reason, I just thought, I was kind of getting sick of waiting. Like, no, that's not true. I was kind of getting sick of just visiting all the time. I don't find sitting in a nail salon like a relaxing, happy time. So so I'm trying to get them back to looking kind of good. I'm gonna use Cover FX powder, but anyway, so. And then I just saw, like, just before I started filming, I saw a ad on Amazon for a DIY S&S, like, kit. And I was thinking it might be good because that way I don't have to file them down like they do. You know, they remove them with a drill, or they, like, de-shine your nails with a drill. I don't want to do that. So at least then I can just do it by hand. And anyway, that might work. I don't know. Let's see. It's about 30 something bucks. And we've got Amazon Prime, so I don't have to pay for shipping, I don't think. I already know that this works. Ow, 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 ow. All right, so I'm looking pale. All right, I'm going to apply my bronzer and stuff with the same puff. I've been really liking this. This came before, maybe just before Christmas, just after Christmas. So this is the Revlon Skin Lights bronzer, and it's really nice. It reminds me a lot of the butter bronzer from Physicians Formula. So if you can't get your hands on Physicians Formula, which it's not as available in Australia, Revlon is pretty much, you know, everywhere. So I'm gonna try this. For the record, it comes with its own puff, so it should work. All right, so there's the powder. And I'm just going to gently buff that in. So if you've never had like a bad ear infection before, the only thing I can tell you it feels like is, you know when you get a really, really sore blind pimple and you're like, how can this small pimple like hurt so much? Really painful, like under the skin, hasn't come to the surface, really sore bump. Well, it feels like that inside my ears, but like a lot more. And so it started off with just this one. One day at the end of the holidays, I started, why are we talking so much about my ear infection? Anyway, let's just move on. I'm in pain. Okay, so the other thing I wanted to talk to you guys about is that I have been I've been succeeding switching over to natural deodorant. And I'm going to do a whole video or blog post about this if you're interested. It got pretty rank there for a while, but I think I'm on the other side of it. I think I found some products that work. So if you're interested in learning more about why I switched over and that sort of stuff, then let me know. It looks, again, I'm going to take you for some photos somewhere bright so that you can see what my skin looks like. My skin looks really so smooth. Again, the under eyes look a little bit crazy at the moment, but I swear it doesn't look like that. I'm going to use Warm Soul by MAC as a blush. And I'm going to grab another little piece, just pat into that. And I really like putting a tiny bit of blush on my nose. I feel like it looks really young and I'm old. And then I'm gonna grab, see this is, my hers has corners. This one doesn't, but I'm gonna grab a little bit here. And there's no reason why you can't use this bit here. I sometimes actually just do this. Do you see what I did? So you can actually just flip it around and use the other side. But for this, I'm just gonna use a clean part and pick up some more powder and just sort of cut it here. So I've got a little bit more definition. And then I'm gonna just jump off camera and I'm gonna do some eye makeup and stuff and I'll be right back. So I'm back. I just did something really quick on the eyes. Like I said, I'm just gonna go do nothing later. So what I did was I dusted off that little bit of bake down here with the puff. And I also had the tiniest amount of fallout here. and I use the puff just to wipe that away as well. So what do you think? I think my skin looks really good. It doesn't look cakey. It looks a little bit dry under my eyes, but I could just put too much like powder. I don't think that's the puff's fault. I didn't put any highlighter on, but let's try that out. Let's put a little bit of highlighter on and see how that will work. So I'm grabbing the sponge and applying just a tiny little bit of Fenty highlighter. Yeah, I think my skin looks good. I think it looks very even, blended, not cakey, not patchy. It certainly was very quick to apply the foundation and everything else. The powders look nice and blended. I don't really want to use this word, but I'm a little shook. Who knew that all along we had this tool in our arsenal? Like, I've had it anyway. I don't want to go on and on and on, but this is the video. This is the end of the video. This worked. Do I suggest you go out and buy a Tati's one? Sure. I think the idea of it is great. Like, it's great shape. Like, it's got lots of little corners and stuff. This one worked just as well, but it was a little bit more difficult finding a clean edge. I've got quite a few of these, like cheap ones from Daiso, like I said. I think, like I said, they're about... well, they'd probably be $280 for a pair. You get them free in other like products. I've got one here from Becca. I've got one here from Laura Mercier. But I think these ones and this one here is sort of the closest to what she's produced. This is a little thicker, I think. You could buy like a week's worth of these and use one every single day, 7 days worth, 5 days worth, whatever. And then pop them in the wash. Tati's onto something here. For $18 US, if you're in America, it's not that big a deal. Like I said, shipping here is a little bit steep. So I'm not going to go out and buy it straight away. But like I said, I will consider purchasing it if there's another product in her line that I like. But for now, Real Techniques. That's the end of the video. Thank you. I don't know what else to say. It's really strange. Thank you so much for watching. Thanks to all of you who reached out on Instagram or Facebook or whatever and passed on your well wishes after you saw about Chloe yesterday. It's very, very much appreciated. I am now going to go edit this video and upload it and have something liquid for dinner because I can't chew. I had ice cream last night because the cold just really soothed my like jaws here, and I'm going to keep talking about this forever, so I'm going to shut up now. Thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you next time. Bye.